Andy with you for another Now Guitar song lesson. Today we're taking a look at the classic Lynyrd Skynyrd, Simple Man. Got a chart for you. Click the link down below and you can get it there. And while you're there, check out the Now Guitar VIP. Secret lessons not available on YouTube, delivered straight to your inbox. Fun little short lessons and great for entertaining your friends and impressing everyone. So check that out on the page while you're there. Not a super tricky song. I'm going to kind of give it to you in levels, give you a bit of beginner action, and then show you how I can specky it up a little bit. But definitely approachable as a beginner. It's essentially three chords. So what are those magical three chords that make up the legendary Simple Man by Lynyrd Skynyrd? They are C, G, and minor. So, in its simplest form, two strums on C, two strums on G, four strums on A minor. That's the heart of what's going on in there. You can get a little busy with the rhythm. You can get some extra anders in there. One, two, ander, ander. Down, down, up, down, 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 up. That's coming up. All right, so that's the heart of it. And then from there, we have these cool little lines that are going on, which at the start when I was demoing that, I was kind of showing you how you can integrate those with the chords. So I'm kind of thinking a lot of people, there's more people who are going to want to learn to play this for themselves or to play play solo or that sort of thing than in a band format. So what I'm going to show you, you can still take it and you can put it into your band sense, but this kind of covers both bases and it sounds really cool. It's a great thing for looking really impressive by putting the melody as well as the chords together. So if you missed it at the start, it's the isn't that cool? So what there is these little leading notes, these melody notes, which are going to tie those chords together of C, G, A minor. So we get open A string, second fret, and then third fret to lead us into our C. And then you strum your chord. From there, we're then going to get where that second finger is, the E there, open D string, then back to the C where the third finger is. So you're kind of just shadowing the shape that you've already got there. Then G. That's a little quick change, that one. But all you need is really just the second finger. And then get your strum after that. And now we get that same little rundown. E, D, C. So you could use your, this time, first finger, open, second finger for the C. A minor this time. So far we've got E, D, C, G chord, E, D, C, A minor. And here's the little techie bit. We're going to get E, G, E, and we're going to reach our fourth finger over to do that. I was going to suggest another way. Yeah, I'll show you another way. If you have trouble with your fourth finger there, but do work on the fourth finger because you know, everyone's got an unco fourth finger to start with. So I'll show you the fourth finger way. Indecisive. All right, so we've got A minor for two strums, O third fret open on the E string, O three, O, A minor. Now, if you have issues with that with your fourth finger, you can just take off your third finger here and you can reach that over. So you're now playing what is actually an A minor 7. Rather than that, it's very similar. But not quite the same. So I suggest you just work on your fourth finger. So, put that all together. O, 2, 3, C. 2, O, 3, G. 2, O, 3, A minor. Up again, O, 2, 3, 2, O, 3, G, 2, O, 3, A minor, O, 3, O, A. You can fit in an extra G there, rather than just E, G, E. That's a bit of an option as well. Integrated with your strums takes a bit, but I tell you what, it's worth the effort because it sounds cool, doesn't it? Putting those two things together, having a melody and chords at the same time, just, you know, building up to it. You might not get it straight away, you might have to come back later and it might just click further, but it's well worth kind of working on this whole thing of joining up melody notes and chords. So as far as the intro goes, we're kind of working backwards there, but that